Hey, welcome to a new Project Kamp video. In this video, we're going to show you all the things we're going to do this year. We have a lot of new projects planned, new people coming, new leaves on the trees, but still the same sweater and the same joke. So this year, we planned a lot of new big renovation projects and construction, things we want to build, regenerating the land and continue landscaping projects, and we have a few big utilities we need to change. But first, let me show you on the map where we currently are at.
So this is a field view of our land. Right now we're in the top yoga deck right here. Here's our base camp where we spend most of our time working and living. And last season we bought this area which we call the middle land. We already cleared and explored it a bit, and our first trailer house is there. And this year we will start moving our living area there. But base camp is still our main place to live and work. Let's go there in the first place.
So before we go into building new things, we have a few things we need to fix in our existing infrastructure. So we're currently in Basekamp. We set this up a few years ago. Still works good, but we have a few things we need to change and improve. For instance, one of the things is we used to have a roof above the workspace, a tarp, but that blew away in the winter. That kind of sucks. So we're going to build a more proper roof on top, similar to the storage containers we built before. I'm going to share drawings because it seems useful on how to build a roof on a 20-foot container. Besides that, the biogas system, we're gonna make it work this year. That's the goal. We're gonna improve our waste area system as well. The shower, we set up with a basin of magnesium phosphate, a new kind of cement.
This is the basin.
But it starts to wear out a bit, so we need to make some improvements there. Plastic roof is still doing all right. The containers itself are pretty good. They got a bit humid in the winter, but now sun is here again, so no problem. Besides that, the garden is growing nicely. Flowers are blossoming. And then we have the Pizza Hut. The Pizza Hut is very essential for the operation, keeps the people happy. But the roof started leaking. Many roof tiles got cracked. We're not sure why. We're gonna dig more into that later. And the oven itself, also the clay starts to wear out, so we're gonna make some upgrades there. So overall, Basekamp's still pretty good, but we need a few upgrades and improvements to make us ready for the next season. And besides Basekamp, we also have some things we want to improve to the office, the little ruin we renovated before. Let me show you. So here we have the sketchy ruin, still standing. Originally we renovated this to be a guest house. However, it was a nice dry space, so we started using it as an office, which has been very helpful because we do a lot of office stuff. You can see more about that later in this video, what we want to do. Anyway, this year we're going to make a few upgrades because we're going to be with more people so we can use it properly as an office. But the downside is a little bit that we want to renovate it and finish it as a guest house, but we're also using it as an office. So it's hard to combine those two together because we want to add the bedroom on the bottom, a bathroom on the top. So we're not sure if we find a way this year to actually make that happen. And what you've seen until now, the base camp and the office, they're all pretty temporary structures. Because the next big thing we want to build is over here in our community center, right there. So here we have it, future community center. So what we have until now is set up for about 30 people. And here we could host 50 people, but also much better shower, toilet, a big kitchen, more dry space. So this is gonna be quite a big upgrade to the whole operation here. But yeah, it's been a bit of a challenge to really move forward with this. It's a bit beyond our knowledge that we have, and it also involves a lot of new complex utility systems. However, a big change this year is that we have an architect coming on site for 3 months to fix it all, no pressure. So yeah, we should make some big steps with this building in terms of really finalizing the drawings so we can start building. But the community center is mainly just a place for people to have their food or to relax or to work, but they're not sleeping in there. For that, we allocated the new area on the land, which is the middle land, which is our new living space. That's quite cool. So let me show you.
So we will move from the community center area to the middle land, right there.
So last year we renovated this old pick trailer and turned it into a little house with very colorful panels. We used a lot of recycled materials for it, which we like. And this year we're gonna apply a similar principle. We're gonna get a trailer, but then with one of those big cooling fridge boxes on top, because usually a lot of that material gets thrown away, but it's very well insulated. So we're going to try to build a house out of that. It's a bit experimental, so we're going to see how it's going to go. The trailer itself is going to be put somewhere here in the middle land. The land itself is pretty nice, a lot of native trees and things to discover. Feels like we've only seen a part of it, so we're going to continue to clear and discover all the things that are here. Because we already found a few cool ruins. And one of them is actually right here. So the goal for this year is to renovate this one. It's a big old granite ruin. It's the first... Oh, it's a lot of brambles here. The first older ruin that we're going to renovate. That's really built hundreds of years ago. So we're going to learn a lot about that. And we also need to make some pipes, like water and electricity, coming from Basekamp and the well to here, to make sure we can have some utility here. We're not sure yet what is actually going to be inside of the ruin, because it's a bit small, it's not really two floors, maybe it's one big one. I don't know, we still need to figure that out once we clean it up. But overall, the principle is we want to create more living spaces on the land so we can be here with more people, because the land itself needs a lot of regeneration because it burns down every few years. So we have a lot of work to do on the landscape. So let me show you a bit more the landscape goals for this year.
To see them more clearly, we're going to jump back to the top rock area.
So the landscape situation is pretty rough because the land burned down a few years ago. So you still find a lot of burned dead trees. And even before that, 10 years before, it also burned down. So it's very likely that the land would burn down again, which is very rough if you think about it. But not that uncommon at all in this region of Portugal, because it's a very common thing that you have all these forest fires because there are a lot of invasive trees mixed with very hot Portuguese summers. It's kind of dangerous. But there are a few things within your landscape that you can do to create a more fire resilient and stronger landscape. And a few things you can do is, one, making sure you have the right vegetation, so the right trees that are a bit more fire resilient. And also just trying to keep as much of the rain and the water on your land as possible. So this is a kind of a big, long-term, ongoing project we have, trying to make this land more fireproof. That said, it's also kind of urgent because you know it's going to burn down and we're living here, so you also don't want to live in a dangerous place. So it's a bit of balancing to find out what we're going to do first and what makes most sense. So what we have planned for this year is, one is, we have the neighbor here and he has a big eucalyptus farm on top of our land. We cannot change anything about that, but we can change what our land looks like. So we're going to make sure we can maintain it more there, really trimming down all the invasive trees and making sure the native tree stays, so it's a bit more fire resilient as somewhat of a fire break for that eucalyptus area. Another area we need to take care of for ourselves is around Basekamp.
So around Basekamp we need to clean up more and remove some vegetation to have more fire safety and space. That will be one work to do soon. And after that we want to deal with this big other patch between the top rock and the base camp.
So we're right now in the middle of that patch between the highest point of the land and base camp. As you can see, there's a lot of vegetation here. On the one hand, these new invasive trees that are growing, but also a lot of still burned dead wood from before the fire. So yeah, this can all catch fire, so it's better to remove it. We're not sure yet what is the best method and the most effective one to either take it all down, which is a bit rough to do, or leave some, or maybe wood chip a lot of it, so we leave a thick layer of organic matter on the soil. In general, that's something we're still exploring, what are the best, most effective ways. But yeah, we're going to take on this patch and continue to explore a bit more what's the best method. Let me actually show you something we did last year, how that's going to go now.
Last year we cut this mimosa patch next to the office, which is now a green field with swales and fruit trees. And on the other side we tried something else.
So last year we took on this area where we debarked the tree, so we took off the bark. It's hard to see now, but if you see some old clips it looks really cool.
All of the bark.
And all the trees are actually dead now, which in a way is good. But the experiment was also that they wouldn't resprout. And we're still not sure if that happens or not, if it's an effective way. So we continue to leave up this area here But it's pretty close to base camp and a little bit dangerous because it's all just like matches standing up waiting to catch fire. But for the sake of testing, we're gonna leave it up. And we do gonna clear a little bit around where the vans are and the tents to keep it safe. But overall, yeah, still exploring if this is an effective method or not. But yeah, in general, taking care of your vegetation is one big thing you can do. And another one is also retaining more of the water from the rain. So let me show you some projects we have in mind for that.
Okay, let's go to the back of base camp where our lake is.
So last year we dug our first lake, which you can see right here. It filled up pretty good actually in the winter, which is really nice to see. One thing we want to do this year is to put a wall there on the back to reinforce it that it doesn't erode. But overall, it's really nice to gather the rainwater. And we also had another cool one, which is on another side of the land, where you have the road in front that acts as a dam, and then the runoff from the granite wall would all be catched into the lake. So we want to make that as well. But it requires a bit of resources, a bit of a big operation, which actually brings me to the next point, that this year, in order to speed up a bit the landscaping work, we're gonna get either a tractor or a digger. So it's gonna be a very long-term project to regenerate this piece of land, but very important to make it more fire resilient. But it's also important for the whole region and many other places in the world as well. So a big part of this project is to document and share everything what we do online so others can use the information or replicate the best things so they can apply it locally. So a big goal next year we have as well is to improve our documentation. But let's go to a more geeky, quiet place for that. All right, so documentation. This is really the part that makes Project Kamp unique because we document the things we build, but also the knowledge we use on the landscape and the social structures on how to set up a community. So a few things we want to do this year. One is improve academy videos. So we already have the section on the website and here we go more in depth explaining specific things. So we need to make a bunch of videos. We want to improve our software that we use for documentation. So all the code is open source online. So if you're on GitHub as a developer and want to help, make sure to sign up, link below. And we're going to spend more time on our UX and UI. So the digital interfaces we have to share. So having more designers here to make the graphics, but also the layouts of the website, things like that. You can also still help with this actually. So you can sign up in the link below. So basically just a lot of improvements around our documentation and what we share open source with you guys in the rest of the world. So how are we gonna do all of this? Good question. So the upside is the team is maturing quite a lot throughout these years. But we're also gonna be with much more people this year, 35, which is the highest amount we ever had. So on the one hand, we have the people that have been here long term. You might have seen them around, familiar faces.
Hello.
Hey.
Joe.
Hey.
Then cool thing this year is also we have a bunch of people from last year coming back and they can hold a few more responsible managing tasks, which is great. And we also have a lot of new people coming that we never know. We hope they fit in. And besides that, we're going to continue to produce a video for you guys each week. So make sure to subscribe. And if you already want to see the next one, make sure to support on Patreon. Because next week, we're going to prepare the space for a lot of people to come. So really get started on all these goals. Anyway, thanks for watching. That's it. And see you in the next video.